Trini Girl Natural. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. As you can see, big hair don't care. And if you want to know how I did it, stay tuned. And this is it. Pretty big, as you can see. Of course, it's summer and humid, and this batch of flaxseed gel is pretty light. So the gel did have something to do with it, but I definitely think the process helped with the volume as well. If you want bigger hair, definitely try it. I'm not really feeling the no part thing. I'm just used to the part. So it just looks, doesn't look like a wig, I don't know. I have seen people mention that they don't really want parts in their hair. So they like doing it this way with no sectioning to just avoid that. And maybe that'll be me eventually. But I feel like right now I still kind of want my part. But I love the shape, the lightness, and of course how big it is. Let me just go put the bobby pin in, I guess, and I'll be right back. Why did I want to try this? First, it's something that I saw in the Curly Girl handbook, like way back when I read it. And it's something that I actually tried once before and I had really good results. So I wanted to give it a try again and see if it still worked with this amount of length and thickness that I've gotten since then. And I wanted to give you guys the scoop on it. So I thought definitely I want to share it with you. And I wanted to see if it makes a difference both for wash day and for styling. I've been kind of rethinking putting shampoo on the top of my hair since the crown is the driest part, usually of most people's hair. And if the crown is the driest part of your hair, it's kind of like, why are you shampooing it the most? And since the water stays at the bottom last and the moisture kind of collects at the bottom last, then if I make the top the bottom, maybe I'll get some more moisture there. The other reason is to try it as a Curly Girl handbook suggestion, because they were saying that we should all kind of be doing our hair like that. And I guess Finer Hair Curly's mentioned volume and lift. The shrinkage is real. So people who are scared of shrinkage, that could be a warning. If it's summer and you want to live your big hair don't care best life, try it. If you are like a sink washer and you kind of do this anyway, definitely let me know. Pros, volume. Pros, probably faster to do because no sectioning, you just kind of go through it. The cons, especially if you have like tighter curls, make sure you have a lot of slip in all your products because, you know, getting your hands through, especially if your hair is thick and everything, like tangles could become an issue and missing spots, I guess, could become an issue in terms of moisture. So you definitely want to take your time and be thorough even if you're not sectioning. I definitely still kind of went through a little bit and tried to just make sure that each section at least, or each bit of hair, at least got some squished in moisture if it didn't get moisture directly. All the products that I used had great slip, thankfully, but I was just wondering how was I going to really rake my fingers from nape to front, like just all the way through, if my hair wasn't loaded with slip products and completely detangled. So make sure your hair is detangled and make sure all your products have lots of slip before you try this. In fact, I'm going to just put it out there. Do not try this at home or try it at your own risk. I'm not recommending that you try it. I just wanted to do it because I haven't done it in a while and I wanted to see what would happen. Fun for me, my neck was killing me by the end. Maybe it was because I was trying to not go too low so the camera could see me. It's kind of difficult to film. And the other con, which that reminds me of, the other con was not being able to see what you're doing. Which, you know, I don't always look. So sometimes I'm like in a shower with no mirror and I just kind of go by feel. But having hair over your face the entire wash day was just a bit much in the end. Product in your face and stuff. I'm probably going to try it again with like a store-bought gel so I can give you guys a better reference point. So I guess that's it. Inverted wash day. Fun experiment. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed at least seeing a different look. Hope you enjoyed all this big hairiness that I'm working with today. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.